差不多，可以，都可以。
OK， Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya。
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 Okay, so we're telling the story about Gop Kumar. We heard how Gop Kumar had gone to Jagannath Puri, and he'd become the king of Puri there.
我们前几节课一直在讲 Gopa Kumar 的历程，他去了 Jagannath Puri， 后来成为了 Jagannath Puri 的国王。
But he was not very happy there. There were some things he was missing. He was missing Vrindavan.And he decided to leave Jagannath Puri and come to Vrindavan.
但是他在 Jagannath Puri 内心并不快乐，他非常思念 Vrindavan. 最终他决定离开 Vrindavan. 他决定离开 Jagannath Puri 去 Vrindavan.
Yeah, there were some difficulties. Being the king is not such an easy thing to do. There was some problems there.
成为国王并不是那么容易的事情，是很困难的。
So, he got a sign from Lord Jagannath. He got a sign from Lord Jagannath that it was all right for him to go there to Jagannath Puri, to leave Jagannath Puri and to go to Mathura. So, he didn't even go to see the deities. He just, offered his obeisances to the chakra on the top of the temple. And he went to Vrindavan.
他得到了主的神像的一个迹象。于是呢他就离开了 Jagannath Puri。他就启程前往 Mathura。他并没有去庙里去参见神像。而是远远地顶拜了庙顶上的 chakra 神碟，便启程。
So he came to, when he entered Vrindavan, first place he went to is a place called Vishramghat. And Vishramghat is a place when you come to Mathura, when you come to Vrindavan, when you come to that place, first of all you take bath there.
当他来到 Vrindavan 的时候，他就去了 Vishramghat 沐浴。就每当人第一次到 Mathura 的时候，刚刚到 Mathura， 他就要首先去 Vishramghat 那里沐浴。
Then he was able to visit Govardhan, and he was able to.Enter into Vrindavan, but his old friends, the people who he used to know, they didn't recognize him.
他又去了戈尔丹山，他进入了 Vrindavan, 而他的那些老朋友现在已经不认识他了。
But he was in their company, and he was, you know, with the cows, and he was drinking the milk from the cows, and in this way he was.Enjoying being in Vrindavan.
但是 Gopa Kumar 他仍然和他的老朋友在一起，和他们一起放牧牛，喝牛奶。他非常喜欢在 Vrindavan 的时光。
And he was continuing to chant his mantra, do his meditation.
他继续念诵他的 mantra， 也继续自己的冥想。
But then, within his heart, he had the desire to see the Lord of the universe.
但是他内心非常想见到宇宙之主。
And he was thinking about Jagannath Puri. He was thinking about Lord Jagannath again. He couldn't, although he'd come to Mathura, he was still thinking about Lord Jagannath.
哎，在这时候呢，他又深深的思念起了加格纳特普瑞，深深的又想念了加格纳特。
Excuse me. So, Gop Kumar was, although he was in Mathura, Mathura is more auspicious than even Jagannath Puri. And it said Lord Krishna always resides in Mathura, in Vrindavan.
事实上呢,
he never leaves there.
Mathura 比 Jagannath Puri 更加吉祥, 因为主 Krishna 他永远居住在 Mathura, 他从不离开 Mathura, Vrindavan.
Krishna is always wandering through the different forests of Vrindavan and performing his different pastimes.
Krishna 会在 Vrindavan 的森林间漫游，在那里举行他的逍遥。
And he's in the company of Lord Balaram and all the cows. And Lord Krishna resides there eternally.
在巴拉拉姆的陪伴之下，他放牧着母牛，他永恒地居住在马图拉。
Even when Akrura came to take Krishna to Mathura, still Krishna was in Vrindavan.
甚至 Akrura 来把 Krishna 带到马图拉的时候， Krishna 也永远地留在了 Vrindavan。
Because it's Vasudev Krishna who goes to Mathura. Shamsundar Krishna, he stays there in Vrindavan.
去 Mathura 的是 Vasudev Krishna, 而 Shamsundar Krishna 留在了 Vrindavan.
But Gop Kumar, he didn't have the spiritual vision to see Krishna everywhere in Vrindavan. He is not so advanced yet. He's still thinking about going back to Jagannath Puri.
可是 Gopal Kumar 他没有灵性的视域，不能在每一个地方都看到 Krishna， 他没有那么的灵性进步，现在他非常的想念 Jagannath Puri.
Because he thought in Jagannath Puri I can always see Lord Jagannath. He's always there on the altar.
他想在扎格纳普瑞，我时时刻刻的都能见到神坛上的主扎格纳特。
But I'm not seeing Krishna here.
可是我在这里却没有见到 Krishna.
And so, but still he went to visit places of Krishna's pastimes and he could feel some special pleasure, some special energy there in these holy places of Krishna's pastimes.
Gopal Kumar 仍然会去看去 Krishna 上演逍遥的各个地方，他在那里能感受到快乐，感受到那里的能量。
So, we'll take him some time. Gopal Kumar is not perfect yet. It's going to take him some time to come to that stage.
Gopal Kumar 现在还不完美。他要达到完美还需要花一段时间。
So he decides, I'm going to go back to Lord Jagannath. I'm going to go back to Jagannath Puri. But when he was on the path, when he was going there, he met some brahmanas who were doing some religious functions.
他现在决定，我要回 Jagannath Puri。回到主扎格纳那里，在路上他遇到一些正在做仪式的 Brahmana。
So these Brahmanas, they were very knowledgeable about the scriptures, and he heard something amazing from them. He heard from these Brahmanas that above the atmosphere, above this planet Earth, there's a world of demigods, which is called Swarga Loka or the heaven, you know, the heavenly planets.
这些 Brahmana 他们对于经典非常有知识。他在从他们口中 Gopal Kumar 听到一些令人惊异的话。在这个地球之上还有半神人居住的地方，名字叫 Svarga Loka， 也就是天堂。
So, Gopal Kumar, he had not been educated really, so he didn't know about this, and when he heard about it, it was a big shock, surprise to him. He heard how in the higher planet, in heavenly planet, there's a superhuman civilization.
Gopal Kumar, 他的知识并不完备，他听到这些话感到非常震惊和惊讶。在天堂难道还有超人类的文明存在着吗？
See, Gopal Kumar, he'd been only living in Govardhan and just been a cowherd boy, so he never got educated really in the Vedic culture. But most people are in India, they all know about, they hear about this because it's the Vedic culture, they hear about the heavenly planet.
Gopal Kumar 只是戈尔丹山的一介牧牛童而已，所以他对于伟大文化并不了解。大部分的印度人都听说过这一切，所以他们印度人对于伟大文化略知一二。
So these Brahmanas, they had read many scriptures, so they were happy to share their knowledge, and they began to teach Gopal Kumar.About what it's like in the heavenly planets.
这些 Brahma 呢，他们熟读经典，于是便开始教导 Gopal Kumar 有关于天堂星宿的知识。
And the Brahmanas told them in the heavenly planets, there's special airplanes, and the people there, they can fly in these airplanes.
他们告诉 Gopal Kumar 在天堂有一种特殊的飞机，天堂的居民们都乘坐这些飞机。
In the heavenly planets, there's no disease. There's no, none of this, deadly virus, COVID virus. There's no old age. There's no death. It's a place where people have no fear.
在天堂星宿，既没有疾病，也没有新冠病毒，既没有老年，也没有死亡，那里的居民没有恐惧。
And the people can travel in these airplanes, which they don't use petrol. They simply they move by the wind, and they don't have any fear of old age or disease or death.
天堂星宿的居民们乘坐着这种飞机，而是不需要汽油的，它是由风所驱动着的。天堂的居民，
yeah, these,
他们没有恐惧。
These miseries are only in the lower planets, like this Earth planet and lower planets. We have here old age, disease, death.
像疾病、老年、死亡这样的问题只存在于地球这样的低等星宿，高等星宿不存在这样的问题。
To go there, you have to perform pious activities in this world. You have to perform. So the people who go there, they're pious people, and they enjoy great happiness.
能去天堂星宿的人们都是虔诚之士，他们履行了虔诚活动，他们在那里非常快乐。
The enjoyment which they have there is much greater than anything we experience here.
那里的享乐比我们在这里所能感受到的要巨大的多。
And the ruler of the heavenly planets is someone called Indra. And Indra is he's the older brother of the Lord of the Universe.
天堂的统治者是一位被称为 Indra 的半神人，他是宇宙之主的哥哥。
The Lord of the universe and the heavenly planets is actually Lord Vamanadeva. Lord Vamanadeva, the dwarf incarnation of the Lord, who covered the universe in three steps, he's the younger brother of Indra.
实际上那里的统治者是 Vamanadeva, 他只用三步就征服了整个的宇宙，他是 Indra 的弟弟。
Now, in the lower planets, there's also some heavenly planets. They're called subterranean heaven. Subterranean heavenly planets. They're in the lower region of the universe. And Lord Vishnu is there, and also Anantashesha.
实际上，有一个地方叫地下的天堂星宿，是在这个宇宙的低等区域。主 Vishnu他是以 Ananta, 主 Vishnu 也在那里，还有 Ananta Shesha 也生活在那里。
And even on this earthly planet, we find sometimes different heavenly places. And in some of these heavenly places, the Lord Krishna will be worshipped.
连我们这个地球区域也有一些地方就好像天堂一样，在这样的地方，这里的人们崇拜 Krishna.
Just like Bali Maharaj, he had conquered the heavenly planets, but then Lord Vishnu came as Vamanadeva and took away the heavenly planets from him. At that time, Lord Vishnu sent Bali down to a lower planet. But that lower planet was a heavenly planet.
比如说巴利大君，他曾经征服了天堂，可是后来 Vamanadeva 拿走了他的王国，维什努他就把他派遣到了一个低等的星宿，可是这个低等的星宿呢，实际上就跟天堂一样。
Yeah, very opulent. And the Lord also said, I'm going to come there with you. He went there with Bali Maharaj and he protected him.
主 Vishnu 就跟 Bali Maharaj 说，我会跟你居住在一起。他也在那里跟他一起，一直保护着巴利大君。
So there are many great personalities living in different places in the universe.
在这个宇宙的不同区域生活着各个伟大的人物。
But the opulence on the heavenly planets and the upper region of the universe, that's the greatest, it's the most opulent.
在这个宇宙的高等星宿上，那里的富裕是这个宇宙中最伟大的富裕。
And powerful demigods live there.
上面居住着强有力的半神人们。
So,on this planet, you often find brahmanas, they perform rituals, they want to go there.
在这个星球上，常常可以看到一些 brahmana 举行各种仪式，一心就想晋升到那里。
So Gop Kumari was hearing about it, so he was also attracted to go there.
Gopa Kumar 听到他们的谈话，就深深受到吸引，也想去那里。
Because there he heard the Lord of the universe is there as the son, he's the son of Aditi, right? Aditi is the mother of the demigods.
他听说宇宙之主也居住在那里，他是半神人的母亲，Aditi的儿子。
Yeah, and Aditi is the mother of the demigods, and of course Lord Vamanadeva also becomes her son there.
Aditi is 半神人们的母亲，因此呢 Vamanadeva 也自然而然的就成为他的儿子。
Okay, so the so Lord Vishnu, he always rides on Garuda, the king of birds, and he goes there to the heavenly planets and he visits different places in the universe. He goes here and there sometimes to kill different demons.
主 Vishnu 他的坐骑是大鸟 Garuda， 他有时候去拜访宇宙的各个地方去杀恶魔。
And by coming there to different places, he gives pleasure to all the demigods. He satisfies them, and the demigods they worship Lord Vishnu, just like he's their own brother.
去了这些不同的地方，主维士努就给半神人们带来快乐。他们感到非常满足，崇拜主维士努，把他当成自己的弟弟来对待。
So Gopkumar, he'd never seen such wonderful things as this. Lord Vishnu riding on Garuda and going to visit different places.So he was very attracted.
Gopakumar 从没见过这样的奇异的景象。主 Vishnu 骑着坐驾 Garuda 去拜访各个的地方，所以他很受吸引。
So this way Gopakumar began to chant his mantra, and he was meditating in his mind like this, that, oh, he would like to go to the heavenly planets, he'd like to seeLord Vishnu riding on Garuda, and he wanted to be there with Indra and the heavenly planets.
Gopakumar, 他一边念诵着自己的曼特勒，一边冥想。他想去天堂，他想去见主 Vishnu， 骑着 Garuda， 他想见到 Indra， 想去见到天堂。
So, by the power of his mantra, after a very short time,An aeroplane came from the heavenly planets, and he was able to climb into the aeroplane, and it flew off and took him to the heavenly planets.
通过念诵这首曼陀罗，很快就有一架飞机从天堂飞来。Gopakumar 爬进这辆飞机，就乘坐这个飞机飞到了天堂。
Yeah, Gopakumar had been chanting the mantra, he'd been following all the rules, doing everything properly. And so the mantra worked for him, and the aeroplane came and took him to the higher planets.
因为 Gopakumar 他严格的念诵曼陀罗，遵守规范原则，并且他的方式方法都是正确的，所以这个曼陀罗就起效果了。
And when he came there to the heavenly planets, he saw Lord Vishnu there. He saw it was the same person who he'd seen in the king's palace before. In the beginning, when he first left Vrindavan, he'd come there to the town, and there was a king's palace there, and he saw Lord Vishnu there in the temple being worshipped there. And he saw the same Lord Vishnu in person in the heavenly planets.
在天堂。Gopakumar 他见到的是同一位，他刚刚离开 Vrindavan， 去在路上去一个国王的宫殿，在那个国王的王国里的一个庙宇里受到崇拜的 Vishnu， Gopakumar 现在亲眼就见到了这同样的人。
He saw Lord Vishnu was sitting on the shoulders of Garuda, and he was surrounded by demigods.And they were all praising him.
他见到 Vishnu 坐在嘎鲁达的肩，主维什努坐在嘎鲁达的肩膀上，四周围绕着众半神人们在赞美他。
And Narada Muni was playing beautiful music, and the Lord was enjoying hearing the vina of Narada Muni.
Narada Muni, 他弹奏着他的维纳琴，奏出优美的音乐。主维什努他非常喜欢听。
The deity which he'd seen in the king's palace was almost exactly the same as the Lord when he saw the Lord in the heavenly planet.
那国王宫殿里崇拜的神像跟他现在在天堂星宿见到的主一模一样。
He was a blackish color, and he was youthful in age, he wasn't old, and he had the four arms holding the different symbols of Vishnu, the conch shell, the disc, and the club, and the lotus flower.
主维什努的肤色黝黑，永远的是年轻人的样子，他永远不会变老。他长着四臂，手里分别拿着维什努的四个标志：海螺、神蝶、大头棒和莲花。
So Lord Vishnu appeared even more beautiful and charming than ever before. Seeing when Gop Kumar saw him, he thought he's looking so beautiful. He was so attracted by the beauty. But here, when he saw the deity, he was surrounded by many demigods.
主维什努他永远是美丽的。Gopa Kumar 他见到他觉得特别，现在见到半神人围绕着他，维什努深深的受到他的吸引。
So this way Gop Kumar was feeling that, oh, now my life is perfect. I wanted to see this. Now my desire has been fulfilled. I'm seeing the Lord of the universe. And he would bow down, offer obeisances, and recite prayers.
Gop Kumar 现在感觉，哦，我的生命已经完美了，我的夙愿终于实现了。现在见到了宇宙之主，他就向他去以顶拜，献上祷文。
But then Lord Vishnu saw Gop Kumar and he called to him and he told him, come here.
Vishnu 一见到 Gop Kumar 就招呼他过来。
And Lord Vishnu spoke to him and said, oh, my dear son of a cowherd, it's very nice that you have come here.
主维什努跟他说，哦，牧牛郎之子，我非常高兴在这里见到你。
And Lord Vishnu tells him, you don't have to bother bowing down. Don't be afraid of me. Come closer.
并且跟他说，你不用麻烦顶拜我，过来，你不用害怕。
Lord Vishnu was happy that he said, you're my dear friend, now you've come here to my place.
主维什努见到他非常的高兴，说，你是我的朋友，你来到了这儿了。
So, Gop Kumar was being very formal and being very respectful, but Lord Vishnu was saying, no, it's okay, don't worry about all that.
Gopa Kumar 他正儿八经的毕恭毕敬的，然后主维什努说，你不用这样呢，没有关系的。
So Indra had some of the demigods take care of Gop Kumar and they brought him a seat.
Indra 和其他的一些半神就很关照 Gopa Kumar，给他拿了一个座位。
And they brought him different offerings of heavenly pleasures, and they took him to reside, they took him to the Nandana forest, a beautiful forest there, and they said, you can stay here.
他们给他端来了供奉的祭品，还有天堂的各种享受的小吃，他们还带他去了 男的呢花园，一个森林，他们说你就可以住在这里。
So Gop Kumar feels so happy here. He said, oh, this is so beautiful, so wonderful. And he knows also that here there's no pain, there's no fear, there's no death, there's no disease, no old age.
Gop Kumar 在这里感到非常的愉悦，他觉得这里非常的美好，这里没有病痛，没有恐惧，没有死亡，没有疾病，没有老年。
So they brought him also the different nectar of the which the demigods enjoy eating there.
他们还给他端来了半神人在那里所吃的甘露。
So Gop Kumar saw this place is, you know, it's not like the earthly planets. We're on our planet, this earth planet, there's so many problems, difficulties. But there they could see there's no problems, no anxiety.
Gop Kumar 在那里看见，那里并没有这个地球星宿所有的问题，没有困难，没有焦虑。
But there were a few some things which were not quite right. He felt a little difficulty. But the happiness which he felt just being.Able to see the Lord of the Universe was so great that he didn't mind some difficulties.
可是 Gop Kumar 却觉得有点地方不对，有一些困难。他在那里呢，能和宇宙之主在一起非常快乐。这种巨大，比起这种快来说，这点困难不算什么。
Because on earth he had never seen the Supreme Lord.Display, you know, show his personality and deal personally with people. He'd only seen the Lord as a deity.
因为在地球，你看不见至尊主，这位至尊的人格人物，他亲身的和别人交往。
But the problem sometimes in the heavenly planets, the demigods would quarrel with each other.They're not able to get along with each other so well. Sometimes they would argue, disagree.
问题是在天堂，半神人们有时候会彼此争吵，没有不和谐。
So every day, Lord Indra would worship the Supreme Lord Vishnu with great opulence.
每一天，主 Indra 都以巨大的富裕崇拜主 Vishnu.
Yeah, he would worship the Lord also as his brother, and as his master, and as his shelter.
他也把 Vishnu 当成他的弟弟、主人和庇护来崇拜。
He would offer items of heaven, special heavenly items like the Amrita, the nectar which they enjoy in the heavenly planets.And he would offer also a special flower called the Parijata flower, which grows in the heavenly planets.
他也供奉给他在天堂的一种饮品 Amrita 喝，还给他供奉在那里天堂生长的 Parijata 花环。
So he was watching Lord Indra worship Lord Vishnu, and he was thinking, "Oh, Indra is so fortunate."He's got all this opulence and he can offer it all to Lord Vishnu. He's enjoying all of this.
Gop Kumar, 他目睹着这一切，他想，哦，他目睹 Indra 崇拜 Vishnu， 他就想，哦， Indra 太幸运了，能这么富裕的，能给他供奉这些好东西，还可以享，供奉让主 Vishnu 享受。
So actually, Krishna had arranged this for Gop Kumar. He wanted Gop Kumar to see all this, and he wanted to attract Gop Gopkumar towards this service of Lord Vishnu.
这一切都是 Krishna 亲自安排的，他想让 Gopakumar 能见到这些，能够被吸引，并且做出服务。
So Lord Vishnu, he always comes to help the demigods because sometimes the demigods are challenged by the demons. So Lord Vishnu comes to help them to keep the, he likes the demigods to rule, doesn't want the demons to rule.
主 Vishnu, 他就会帮助半神人，因为半神人们有时候受到恶魔的挑战。主 Vishnu 不希望恶魔统治，而是希望半神人来统治。
So Gopkumar was thinking, will the Lord of the universe ever give me that mercy that maybe I can also worship him like Indra is doing?
Gopakumar 就想，哦，宇宙之主什么时候给我仁慈啊？我也想像 Indra 那样崇拜他。
So Gopkumar was still chanting his japa, doing his meditating on the mantra and doing his japa. And then he hoped that maybe one day I'd be able to worship the Lord properly with all this opulence.
Gopakumar 就继续念诵自己的 japa, 继续冥想。他心想，有一天我要是能像 Indra 这样富裕的崇拜为什么就好了。
So, after some time it happened that Indra, he did something wrong. He forced the wife of one of the great sages to give him sex.
有一次 Indra 犯了一个错误，他强迫一位圣哲的妻子来满足他的性。
So,After he did this, he was very ashamed. Indra was ashamed. And he knew that the sages would curse him for what he'd done.
这之后 Indra 感到羞愧难当，他知道圣人会为此诅咒他。
So Indra had to, he went to hide somewhere.
Indra 就跑到一地方躲起来了。
And when Indra went to hide, then nobody was Indra. And so there's a problem for the demigods.
Indra 躲起来之后，现在就没有 Indra 了，所以对半神来说就成问题了。
The demigods searched everywhere for him, but they couldn't find him.
半神到处找 Indra, 但是找不着。
Just like one time before, Indra...killed a brahmana and he went to hide and he hid himself in the stem of a lotus flower.
就像有一次 Indra 曾经杀死一位 brahmana, 他就躲进了莲花的梗茎当中。
So because Indra was not ruling, so then it made it very easy for the demigods to give trouble and they started to create a lot of trouble within the universe.
因为现在缺乏了 Indra 的统治，现在呢，恶魔就趁虚而入，给宇宙造成了骚乱。
So then the demigods ordered, they were told by Lord Vishnu, because Lord Vishnu is their original spiritual master, there's their guru. And he tells them that.This Gopkumar, he should become Indra.
因为 Vishnu 是原初的 Guru, 因此 Vishnu 就告诉半神人，现在这一位 Gopakumar, 他应该担任 Indra.
And Indra's mother, Aditi, she approved. She said, yes, let this Gopkumar take the position for my son.Because she knew they have to have somebody on the throne, they have to have somebody ruling.
半神人的母亲 Aditi 也同意了，她就想，因为必须得有人坐在 天地的宝座上，代替他的儿子来行使职位。
Yeah, everybody agreed that Gop Kumar would be the right person. And all, even Indra's wife, Indra's mother, and all the friends of Indra, they all agree that Gop Kumar, he's the right person. Let him become the ruler of the heavenly planets.
每个人都同意 Gop Kumar 担任 Indra, 他的妻子、母亲、朋友都认为 Gop Kumar 是担任这一职位的正确人选。
Yeah, Indra is a position. It's not a person's name. It's actually a position. It means somebody who's like the king or the ruler.
Indra 是一个地位，就是一个统治者，类似于国王的地位。
So in this way, Gop Kumar became Indra, and he was doing all the different services which the king is supposed to do.
Gop Kumar 于是便当上了 Indra, 履行了 Indra 的服务。
And he began to encourage everyone to do pure devotional service everywhere in the three worlds.
他鼓励每一个人都从事纯粹的奉献服务，在三个世界全都从事纯粹奉献服务。
He honored the spiritual master, the spiritual master's name Brihaspati. And he honored all the brahmanas.
他荣耀了guru, Brihaspati, 半神的 guru, 也荣耀婆罗门 brahmana 们。
So, Gop Kumar used his position as Indra.To spread Krishna consciousness throughout the universe.
Gop Kumar 用他的地位在宇宙，在全宇宙传扬奉献服务 Krishna 之觉。
And Gop Kumar was trying to encourage them in full devotional service.
他也鼓励他们从事于全心全意的意思。全心全意的奉献服务
meaning without any material motive
也就是没有任何物质动机的纯粹无暇的奉爱服务
OK. Then what happened thenSo while Gop Kumar was ruling with full authority, he continued to live in the forest where he'd been living. He didn't move into the palace of Indra. He stayed living in the forest.
Gop Kumar 统治期间，他继续居住在森林里，并没有搬到 Indra 的宫殿里居住。
And he lived in the humble style, the same way he would live. Because he's a cowherd boy, so he used to living simply, humble.
他以他的生活方式是谦卑而简朴的，因为他身为牧牛童，所以喜欢简朴的生活。
And he preferred to live away from the city rather than in the, he's living in the forest.Didn't like to live in the city in the palace. He wanted to live naturally.
他喜欢远离城市居住，他不喜欢住在宫殿里，他喜欢居住在森林。
And he didn't become proud or arrogant. You know, he kept himself very humble, simple.He never gave up chanting his japa, but he was always, in that way, he was always able to remember about Vrindavan.
他没有变得骄傲傲慢，他仍然保持着非常谦卑和简朴，但同时呢，他继续念诵自己的 japa, 他也 在内心铭记着文达本。
Gop Kumar, although he was living in heaven, he thought, actually he said that he preferred, the better life was in Vrindavan when he was a cowherd boy, just being with the cows. He thought that was actually the best life.
虽然 Gop Kumar 身居天堂，他觉得能在 Vrindavan 和母牛能当一个在 Vrindavan 和母牛在一起更好，在那里当一个牧牛童也很好。
Because he's always chanting the mantra to Madan Gopal. So Madan Gopal always in Vrindavan. So he, Gop Kumar was also thinking about Vrindavan. So he felt very grateful to the mantra. And he didn't want to stop chanting the mantra.
他非常感恩这首曼陀罗，他不从来没有停止念诵曼陀罗。
So he was remembering Vrindavan. He'd feel pain. The separation from Vrindavan would be painful for him, and his face would dry up.And the Lord of the Universe saw this.
他非常思念文大本，感到跟那里的分离之苦，连他的面容也逐渐的干枯起来。宇宙之主注意到了。
And the Lord of the Universe would try to console Gop Kumar, and he would even rub his head and, you know, speak kind words to him, try to help him to.Forget about Vrindavan.
宇宙之主便安慰起 Gopakumar, 他抚摸他的头，对他好言好语，想让他忘记 Vrindavan.
And Gopakumar, because he's Indra, and he's like the elder brother of Vishnu, so.When he would offer anything to the Lord would accept it.
Gopakumar, 他是 Indra, 就像 Vishnu 的哥哥一样，所以每次他给 Vishnu 供食物的时候， Vishnu 都会亲自的接受。
He would like to please Gopakumar.
他也想取悦 Gopakumar.
He knew Gop Kumar is only going to be on the throne temporarily. He's not going to stay for long. But the Lord was happy to have him like that as a brother.
He knew Gop Kumar is only going to be on the throne temporarily. He's not going to stay for long. But the Lord was happy to have him like that as a brother. He was happy to have Gop Kumar as a brother.
So Gop Kumar would enjoy this, being able to offer worship to the Lord. And he would enjoy taking care of the Lord like his younger brother.
Gop Kumar, 他非常享受能够这样来崇拜 Vishnu, 并且把他当成自己的弟弟来照顾。
Gop Kumar would sometimes, he would be able to touch the hands of Lord Vamanadeva and even embrace him.
Gop Kumar 有时候能够触碰到 Vamanadeva 的手，拥抱他。
Yeah, usually we won't do that, but because Gop Kumar was in so much ecstasy, it was allowed.
通常我们都不会这样去做，因为 Gopakumar 他在极乐当中，所以他有时候会这样去做。
So when Gopakumar would be in this mood of feeling pain from Vrindavan, the Lord would come and comfort him and help him to get over it. And then the Lord would go away and leave him.
Gopakumar 呢，他感受到跟 Vrindavan 的分离的非常痛苦，有时候呢，主就会来安慰他，给他说上一些话，然后就走了。
So then when the Lord would leave, he wouldn't be able to see him anymore. So you feel that, you know, separation, that, oh, where is he? I can't see the Lord.
等主走了之后，格瓦库马尔就见看不见他了，他就会感，他现在就觉得又感想念他，就想哦，我的主，你去哪了
？So he is very anxious to get the mercy of the Lord, but he saw that he's not able to get so much mercy here in the heavenly planets.
他非常的焦虑的想得到主的仁慈。但是他在天堂这里，他看到他得不到很多的仁慈。
The Lord had protected him from getting proud, and he had allowed him to worship the Lord in opulent style.
主保护他，不至于陷入骄傲的情绪当中，并且能够允许他以一种富裕的方式来崇拜他。
But sometimes the Lord would go away, he'd go to visit different places, and Gop Kumar never knew where he'd gone.
可是主有的时候就会到别的地方去拜访， Gop Kumar 不知道他去了哪里。
No, the Lord of the universe would go with Lakshmi, his consort, and Gop Kumar wouldn't be able to see either of them.
宇宙之主有会和他的伴侣 Lakshmi 一起走掉，Gopa Kumar 这时候呢，就哪一位也见不到了。
Yeah, after some time, the Lord would come back, but still that was not enough for Gopa Kumar.
过一段时间之后呢，他又会再次回来，但是 Gopa Kumar 就觉得自己跟他见到他的时间不够长。
So Gop Kumar was thinking about going back to Jagannath Puri to be with Lord Jagannath because he knew Lord Jagannath never gives up on the people who come to him.
Gop Kumar 很想回到 Jagannath Puri, 因为主 Jagannath 从来不放弃一位来到他面前的人。
He thought Lord Jagannath's love for his devotee is better than Lord Vishnu in heavenly planets.
他认为主扎格纳塔对他奉献者的爱比维什努对他崇拜者的爱更加伟大。
Lord Vishnu is always present, but Lord Jagannath is always present, but here in heavenly planets, sometimes Vishnu is here, sometimes he's not, he's coming and going.
主扎格纳塔时时刻刻都在那里，而维什努他是来来去去，有时候在，有时候不在。
But then when Lord Vishnu would come again, and then he would give mercy to Gop Kumar, and then Gop Kumar would feel, oh, I can't leave here, I have to stay here, it's so wonderful here.
可是每次 Vishnu 来就会给 Gop Kumar 仁慈， Gop Kumar 就想，哦，这里这么好，我也不想离开这儿啊。
So this is a situation again. So then Gop Kumar, he lives there in the heavenly planets ruling as Indra, and he's happy. He's, in this way he spent 1 year of the demigods there.
Gop Kumar 就居住在天堂统治着那里，他就在那里待了一年的时间。
Yeah, yeah, and Gop Kumar has to do all the duties of Indra, which is also, Indra is in charge of the rain.
他必须要履行Indra 的职位， Indra 的职务， Indra 是负责掌管雨水。
And he has to maintain also the Brahmanas do the yagya all the time and offer the Vedic sacrifice.
他也要确保Brahmana 们做yagya.
And he has to maintain and protect the universe.
他还要保护和维系宇宙，确保那些Brahmana 供奉伟大的仪式。
So in this way, Gop Kumar, he spent 1 year of the heavenly planets. 1 year in the heavenly planets is 360 years on this planet.
360 所以 Gopal Kumar 就在天堂待了一年，就相当于地球上的36000年。
But then, what happened was some great sages came. Great sages, headed by Bhrigu.And they came there, and they came to visit Swargaloka. They came to Indra's planet. And he had never seen these people before.
结果呢，有一天就有来了一些圣人，以 Bhrigu 为首的圣人，他们来到 Swargaloka. 嗯 ，Gopal Kumar 从来没见过。
They were going to purify the holy places on the Earth planet.
他们将要去地球去净化圣地。
So Gop Kumar, he didn't know who these people were or where they came from.
Gopal Kumar 不认识这些人，不知道他们从哪儿来的。
They're actually, Bhrigu is actually born from the mind of Brahma.
Bhrigu 实际上是从 Brahma 的心意诞生的。
And there are seven great sages. They live above the heavenly planets, and the planet above the heavenly planets.
有七大圣人，他们居住在天堂之上的星宿。
So Gop Kumar, this is just amazing. Like, who are these people? Where have they come from?
Gopal Kumar, 他感到很惊讶，这些圣人是谁呀？从哪儿来的？
So, we'll hear about that tomorrow, or next class. When we go on, we'll stop there today.
今天我们就讲到这儿，下节课继续。
Are there any questions?
有问题吗？
是的。我们现在有一个问题，仆人奎士纳从没有离开文达文，为什么阿库拉接走奎士纳，牧牛姑娘如此悲伤呢？
奎士纳 never leaves Vrindavan, but why gopis felt so sad when Akura took Krishna away from Vrindavan?
Well, when Krishna was there, yet he didn't want him to go, right? Of course, he didn't want him to go. So after he left, the gopis, they were in the fire of separation.
Krishna 不想去。在 Krishna 离开之后呢，牧牛姑娘他们就处在分离的烈火当中，他们内心在分离的烈火当中，在那里非常感到很疼痛。
This is Krishna performing the pastime of leaving Vrindavan. This was to increase the ecstasy of the gopis.
Krishna 上演。离开文达文的消时光是增加了勾皮们的狂喜。
Actually, what happened was when Krishna was going away from Vrindavan, he hid himself in the hearts of all the gopis.
事实上当 Krishna, 离开文达文之后他就 躲进了勾皮们的内心。
So, the gopis, they had to,realized Krishna more in their heart after he left there.
在 Krishna 离开文达安之后，勾皮们不得不觉悟 Krishna 就在他们的心中。
So there's different ways in which we can understand this. We know actually Krishna, he's always there in Vrindavan. Every night he's dancing Rasa Leela there in Vrindavan.
对此有不同的理解方式，但实际上呢 ，Krishna 他永远都没有离开 Vrindavan， 每天晚上都在那里跳舞。
So Krishna appears to have left Vrindavan, but actually he never leaves Vrindavan.
Krishna 好像是离开 Vrindavan, 但实际上是没有离开。
But by his appearing to leave Vrindavan, it allows the devotees to feel the separation that Krishna's going is a greater ecstasy, increase the affection and the attachment for Krishna. When you know that you're going to lose someone, you feel more attached to them.
Krishna 表面上离开 Vrindavan 是允许奉献者们感受分离之情，增加他们的狂喜，增加他们对他的爱和依附。
That separation of leaving Krishna, then that leads to the union, because after feeling the separation from Krishna, then Krishna comes back, and then the gopis feel relieved from the separation.
This 种分离之情呢，就增加了他们的依附和爱，就允许当 Krishna 再次回来之后呢，他们会缓解他们的分离之苦，实际上呢是更胜于和他在一起。
Just like every morning, Krishna would go off to the forest with the cows, so the gopis would feel separation. They would watch him go. They'd feel separation the whole day. They'd feel separation. They'd wait for him anxiously to come back in the evening.
就像 Krishna 每天早上离开家去放牧母牛的时候，勾皮们就会感到强烈的分离之情，他们就一整天盼望着 Krishna 回来。
So it's a very transcendental experience, feeling the separation from Krishna, and then having again the union with Krishna.When Krishna comes back.
实际上呢，这是一种超然的体验，感受着跟 Krishna 的分离之情。等 Krishna 再次回来的时候，又享受跟他的相聚。
And so Krishna leaves, but at the same time he never leaves. He's just hiding himself.From the gopis for some time.
Krishna 离开了，又同时没有离开，他只是从 gopi 们那里躲起来了，只是在一段时间离开。
Because Krishna likes to increase the ecstasy of the devotees, he wants to give them more ecstasy.So by putting them into these difficult situations, it increases their ecstasy.
Krishna 喜欢增加奉献者的极乐和狂喜，喜欢他们的狂喜更多，所以喜欢把他们放在一些困难的处境当中。
Okay, any other question?
下一个问题。《薄伽梵歌》第八章十六世界说，物质世界从最高到最低的星球都是生死轮回的痛苦之地。如何理解今天课中那些 Brahmana 告诉 Gopakumar 天堂里没有痛苦呢
？Yeah, okay. So we have to understand that everywhere there'sBirth and death. You take birth there for some time. You have to leave that place. You have to give up that body. And so the heavenly planets, it's not like death on our planet.
我们要明白，生死到处都存在着。只要有生就有死亡。出生一段时间后，必须要离开这个躯体，放弃这个躯体。但是 在天堂的死亡跟我们地球的死亡不一样。
Right. We know our planets and the lower planets, there's old age and the disease and then death, painful. But in the heavenly planets, it's not like that.
在我们这个地球这样的低等星宿呢，有老年、生病、死亡，非常痛苦。但是在天堂跟我们这儿不一样。
But at the same time, heavenly planet, you go there, you can't stay there forever. You come there, you enjoy your pious activities, and after you've enjoyed all the pious activities, then you have to leave there.
在天堂不是永远的，人去了天堂之后，享受他们的前程活动，然后呢，之后又必须要再度离开天堂。
So it's all temporary.
一切都是短暂的。
The opulence of the heavenly planets is also temporary.
天堂的富裕也是短暂的。
We will hear how the heavenly planets, they also get destroyed at the end of Brahma's day. At the end of each day of Brahma, all the, from the heavenly planets down, all the planets are destroyed.
我们在后面会听到，在 Brahma 的一天结束的时候，天堂是怎样归于毁灭的。
Those sages who just came, we just heard about those sages, they came from a planet above the heavenly planets. Those planets are not destroyed at the end of Brahma's day.
我们刚才在课中听到，从天堂之上的星球来了一些圣人，在 Brahma 的一天结束之后，那圣人们居住的那些星球不毁灭。
But the heavenly planets are all destroyed.
而天堂会归于毁灭。
At the end of Brahma's day.
在 Brahma 的白天结束，一天结束之后。
Mm-hmm. 下一个问题。
下一个问题， Gopal Kumar 正确的念诵了 mantra 就有效果。同样，我们在能正确的念诵圣名的时候，我们在念诵圣名的时候，是不是没有正确的念诵，所以就没有效果，对吗？我们怎么才能正确的念诵呢
？Well, when we stop committing offenses, then that will be the pure chanting.
当我们停止冒犯的时候，就是纯粹的念诵。
We have to understand to chant on the level of Baba.Then to understand that the holy name is not different from Krishna in person.
当达到巴瓦阶段的时候，人会明白圣名跟 Krishna 这一个 Krishna 本人没有区别。
Just like Gop Kumar is feeling ecstasy when the Lord of the Universe was there, he was able to directly worship him. So when we chant the holy name, we should understand the Lord is there with us.
就像Gopal Kumar, 他感到狂喜，他可以直接崇拜宇宙之主，就在那直接崇拜。同样，当我们念诵圣名的时候，我们应该直接感觉到 Krishna 就在那里。
So, it's a very special thing to be able to chant the holy name. We have toUnderstand properly the theology, the science behind its chanting and the power of the holy name.
能够唱诵圣名，这是非常独特的。我们应该正确的能够唱诵，明白这个念诵后面的所有的神学、科学以及方法。
And we have to really endeavor to chant better than what we're doing. Then we will get the full result.
我们应该努力的比我们现阶段念得更好，去取得念诵的全部的效果。
下一个问题。
好，下一个问题，喜宝苏巴转马达基的问题，顶拜咕噜和翻译，如果每天坚持规范修习，仍然感觉到心意晃动，很难专注念诵，也无法回到物质生活，请问如何调整才能将心意专注于 Krishna 知觉呢？谢谢。
Uh-huh. How can we fix the mind?
Her question is that although following all the regulative principles, the mind is still wandering, but at the same time, she cannot return back to the material world. So how can she adjust, 调整心, adjust the...
Well...
怎样调整心, 怎样 adjust this, her mind?
Well, it's good your mind doesn't want to go back to the material world. You want to continue with the spiritual practice and keep chanting and try to perfect it.
非常好, 就是你的心意现在不想回到物质生活, 这是非常好的事情, 你只要继续灵修, 努力地去完美。
Yeah, sometimes, you know, when as we come to in the beginning of Krishna consciousness, we're thinking, oh, maybe I'll just go back to material world, this is too much, maybe I'm not bothered. But now you're at least you're convinced that you don't want to go back to material world. So that's very good.
一开始接触Krishna之觉之后呢，我们就有时候会还想着，哎呦，我干脆再回到物质世界去吧。 但是您至少还想着您不想再回到物质世界了，是非常好的。You
have to develop the Krishna consciousness 24 hours a day. That you have to, everything has to be in, done in Krishna consciousness. You want to become more and more.
您必须要一天24小时的有 Krishna 直觉。 在一切都行在Krishna之觉当中。 Hare Krishna. Maharaj?
Hare Krishna, 是Guru。 我们听不到他了，是吧？
好像是。
Hare Krishna, good day. 我们听不到你了。Hare Krishna, 亲爱的奉献者，因为现在圣地可能是这个暴风雨，然后停电，我们暂时 连线不上Guru了，我们今天的早课就先到这里结束吧，后面剩下的问题没有回答的，我们在下次课周六的晚上可以请Guru回答，好吗？顶拜所有的奉献者，Hare Krishna。